In a series of videos, we are learning HTTP client module. In the previous video, we implemented the code to make the backend call and display the list of countries. In this video, we will have a detailed look into the coding implemented in the previous video. Routing topic is already covered in this course, hence explanation is not required on the changes made in app-routing.module.ts and app.component.html. If you are not familiar with the changes made in these two files, check the videos related to routing in this course. Rest of the changes are made in list component class and its HTML template. I will explain the implementation in these two files using a diagram. This is the code in the list component class. Due to space constraint, the line in ng onInit function is wrapped and included in two separate lines. This is the code in HTML template of the list component. Let me walk through based on the code execution flow of the Angular application. When the Angular application starts, its components are loaded. When list component is loaded, its constructor is first called. Now the HTTP client service gets injected through the constructor parameter. If you are not familiar with the word inject, check the dependency injection video in this course. After the execution of the constructor, HTTP becomes a property of the list component with data type as HTTP client. The HTTP client service is available through the import of HTTP client module, which we imported in app module in one of the earlier video. Now coming back to the code execution flow, after the constructor, the ng onInit function is called. In ng onInit, this dot HTTP refers to the HTTP client service. In the HTTP client object, get function is called. The get function is called passing the REST API endpoint as input parameter. This initiates the call to the respective backend REST API endpoint. In this example, we are using JSON server as backend service, which is running in our desktop. In the real-time actual scenario, the REST API will be available in the network. When network is involved, there will surely be a time latency. We may get the response in milliseconds or after few seconds or few minutes, or we may not get the response at all. This affects the execution flow of the code running in the browser. Let us assume that code execution flow halts when backend call is made and the code execution flow waits till the response is received. If this happens, the code execution flow will stop at the first line of ng onInit function. The browser gets freezed and the user will not be able to use the browser tab till the backend response is received, which will not be a good user experience. To handle this network latency, the get function returns an observable object. In the observable object, we are calling the subscribe function. The observable object and subscribe function makes it possible that program execution flow does not stop in this line when waiting for response from the server. Let me demonstrate in Visual Studio Code that code execution flow is not halted when making backend call. I have already started the Angular application using ngserve command, and I have also started the JSON server. I am including a console log that prints the country's property after the line where the backend call is made. I am saving the file. After the page reload, in the console log, the value of country's property is printed as undefined, but in the web page, we can see that the countries are listed. Let me further explain this in Visual Studio Code. This is the line where backend call is made. This is the line that prints countries, which is getting displayed as undefined. This clearly means that the console log line is getting executed even before receiving country's data from backend. The console log line is not waiting till data is received from the backend. Hope this demonstration helps you understand that code execution flow is not halted because of backend call. Let me further explain in the diagram. The usage of observable object and subscribe function helps to create this asynchronous behavior. After execution of the first line in ng on init function, a separate line of execution is initiated by the browser to get the response data from the backend, and another separate line of execution continues the normal execution flow of the Angular application. The normal execution flow completes the execution of ng on init function and it displays the page in the browser. At this point of time, only the page heading is displayed and countries are not listed as data is not yet received. The other line of execution to get backend data is managed by observable object, which waits till the data is received. Once data is received, the countries gets displayed in the browser. Hope this explanation helps you understand how observable object plays an important role in creating two parallel lines of code execution, where one line of execution helps in not freezing the browser and the other line of execution gets the data from backend. We will now have a detailed look on how data received from backend gets displayed in the page. The backend response contains the JSON of country list. Once the JSON response data is received, the observable object calls the callback function, which is passed as parameter of subscribe function. The callback function is defined as an arrow function having data as parameter and a single line as arrow function body. When observable object calls the callback function, the JSON data is converted to JavaScript object and passed as parameter of the callback function. When the body of the callback function is executed, the backend response data gets assigned to country's property. Once country's property is updated, the countries in the ng4 directive receives the data. It repeats the li tag based on the number of entries in the country's array and displays the country details using interpolation. This completes the explanation of the end-to-end execution of the code implemented in the previous video. Now, using Visual Studio Code, I will demonstrate the two separate lines of execution. I am going to introduce a delay in the backend response so that we can clearly see the two separate lines of execution. I am getting into the terminal window of JSON server and stopping the server. Using up arrow, I am getting the command to start the server, and in this command, I am including a delay of 5 seconds. When a request comes to the JSON server, it is going to send the response back only after 5000 milliseconds, which is 5 seconds. I am pressing Enter key to run this command, which starts the JSON server. Now in the browser, I am reloading the countries page. First, we see only the page heading. After 5 seconds, we can see the countries getting listed. Let me explain this using code. When the first line of ng onInit function is executed, one line of execution proceeds ahead with execution of subsequent lines and it does not wait till data is received. Hence, we were able to see the web page having only the page heading. At this point of time, observable object waits till backend data is received and provides the data after 5 seconds, which displays the countries in the web page. Hope this demonstration helps you understand the two lines of execution. Hope all this code execution flow explanation and demonstrations help you understand how the backend call is made, how data is received, and how it is getting updated in the HTML template when using HTTP client. Later, we are going to use HTTP client for different operations, and this execution flow explained in this video remains the same for all the other types of operations. The explanation provided in this video may give rise to more questions, which I am going to list out now. What is the purpose of using observable? JavaScript already supports asynchronous behavior using promise, which can be implemented using fetch API. Why is promise not used by HTTP client? How does HTTP client make the backend call? Under the hood, how the transfer of data happens between HTTP client and backend? We will get answers to all these questions in the subsequent videos.